Hi everyone, I'm Georgette. I was diagnosed with Friedreich's ataxia when I was 15 years old. I'm now 23, so I've had a few years to process and digest the information, and I've been asked to speak about, well, the title of the talk is It Works For Me, and I meant to speak about that and tell you about what works for me and how it works for me. So originally when I got given this task, I was trying to think of things I could mention, such as university, traveling, friendship, music festivals, relationships, just things that people take for granted and maybe somebody with ataxia might find them a little bit daunting. So I was trying to think how I could speak for a long time about one of these subjects, and then I realised that actually it's quite boring. So instead, what I'm going to talk about is how my mindset and my perception of things has altered over the last few years, which has enabled me to be able to do more things and live the life that I want to live. This is something that has bugged me for as long as I can remember, but it wasn't until the first year of uni that I kind of worked out why it annoys me. And that is when people say, "You've done this despite your ataxia." But the reason being, when I was in first year of uni, going into first year was really difficult to get set up. I had so many meetings with different advisors and different people who were helping me financially and like helping me with how to navigate the campus and stuff like that. That took months and months of preparation. So for then to have people say to me, "It's good that you're going to uni despite ataxia," I don't know, it didn't sit right with me. And I thought more on this, and the reason that it doesn't sit right is because everything I do with ataxia. I don't do despite it. I never wake up one morning and think, "I'm going to forget I have ataxia today and do this." It's always, "I'm going to do this. My ataxia might not like it, but I'll put up with it." I spent so long going to meetings and sorting out uni and making it okay, and the reason that I had to spend all of that time was because of my FA. So for people to kind of push that to one side and say, "You're doing so well despite ataxia," it just seemed really offensive. And I think that's definitely changed my perspective on life. I don't look at ataxia as like an enemy anymore. I'm not doing anything despite having ataxia. In fact, I'm doing more stuff with ataxia and because of ataxia. You know, my interest in like health and clinical psychology stems from having FA. I write for a magazine on rare diseases, and obviously none of that would be even plausible without ataxia. Some days I don't want to get out of bed, and the psychological impact of having a severe disability is not something I recommend to people. But I definitely think I would not be where I am today in terms of things I've achieved if it wasn't for my ataxia. So my first topic that I want to speak about is how health does not determine success. And this was something that it took me a while to kind of grasp and understand, but I think the way we as humans view success isn't always correct. For example, when I was growing up, I wanted to go to a top university, get really good grades, get an amazing degree, get married, move away from home, have children, get an amazing job. And I think all of that is great, and it is definitely something to aim for if that's what you want. But it's not the only definition of success. So I think in a way that I think being diagnosed at that age, you do go through kind of a mourning period where you're kind of grieving for the life that you thought you were gonna live, because it doesn't seem possible. And the reason that it doesn't seem possible is not because uni is really hard. It's not because you won't find someone who wants to marry you. It's because your perspective's changed and your mindset has changed. Yeah, you go through a mourning period, and I definitely think for me that was one of the most difficult bits about being diagnosed. Kind of having to accept that the life that I'd wanted was not gonna be possible, or maybe would need to be done in a slightly different way. The turnaround from that is every single day I wake up and I have to prioritize what it is that I really want to do that day, because I don't have the energy to do everything. And that is kind of the same in life. I have to prioritize the things that I really want to do, because I don't have the time and energy to do everything. So it's a blessing, because the things that I'm doing with my life, it's the things that I really want to be doing. It's the things that I'm prioritizing. Everything that I do and spend time on, it's stuff that is really important to me. When I was first diagnosed, very lost in the sense that I didn't have anyone to look up to, or anyone in the media, or anyone doing cool things that had a disability. And that would have been something that was really useful to me. So using that, I kind of think now that things I want to be doing, and the things I say yes to, and the things that I push myself to do, are the things that little me would have wanted to see someone do. My main goal is to kind of imagine that 15-year-old me still existed and be able to inspire her to be in a better place and know that it'll be fine, it's all gonna be okay. So I wanted to end this video by saying that the reason it's worked for me is because it has to. And what I mean by that is, if you are newly diagnosed and you're sat at home thinking, can't do what I need to do, I can't do what I want to do, it won't work, it won't be possible, honestly, it will be possible. And the reason for that is because you don't have a choice. You've got ataxia whether you like it or not, so you might as well like it, and you might as well take the good from it, take the positives, and do what you can. I'm really grateful that I've had the experience that I've had with ataxia, because not many people get to experience it. Bye!